Welcome to Talking Water, a monthly segment where we talk all things water and recycled water, brought to you by our sponsor, East Gippsland Water. Hello and welcome to the program. This month, we welcome Neville Pearce, Executive Manager, Sustainability and Infrastructure, to the program. Hello and welcome, Neville. It's great to have you back.
Hi, Damien. It's great to be back.
Well, Neville, when we had you on the program last year, you were obviously in a different role. What has happened since you were here on the program? And can you let the listeners know a little bit about the new role at East Gippsland Water and why the change?
Thanks, Damien. My last role that I was involved with was the Executive Manager of Service Delivery. And towards the end of last year, I took on the role of Executive Manager, Sustainability and Infrastructure. Mm-hmm. It became vacant and I was asked if I'd like to take on this role as a new challenge. And I accepted, gratefully accepted. It was fantastic, actually. So I've been in the new role for a few months and I've been concentrating on our highest priorities, capital works projects, asset planning, much of which I'll be talking about today.
Okay.
We have just appointed my replacement in the new role, Executive Manager Service Delivery, Hamish Reid is his name, and I'm sure he'll come and speak to you in future programs.
I was going to say I look forward to that.
Yep, which would be great. And he commences in the role around the end of March, early April, just after Easter.
Okay, fantastic. Well, welcome aboard. Again, thanks, Neville. Congratulations on your new role. Can you tell us a bit about the projects you'll be working on?
Yep, thanks, Damien. We'll do. Probably the biggest project that we're working on at the moment is replacing the basin liner at Wyong Water Storage Facility. So that's been in planning for a number of years. It's an 88 megalitre basin and it's an important piece of infrastructure that supplies pretty well the majority of our customers. So it's Bairnsdale and all the surrounding areas down to Painesville Lakes entrance and the like. So pretty significant infrastructure. We detected an issue with the polypropylene liner, and so that's the plastic liner on the basin, and it keeps the water quality at a very high quality. And we detected that was compromised with its integrity and resulted in a leak into the under-drainage pipe. This pipe has been isolated to stop the leak, but because of that, we've identified that we needed to undertake the capital upgrade.
Right.
So over the past few months, we've been undertaking preparatory works to prepare the basin for the replacement works, the liner replacement works, and it has involved testing our brand new 36 megalitre concrete water storage tank that was built just over 18 months ago, and that is now being used as the main water supply system for all the customers and all the people in the region.
Nice.
It's worked really well. It provides customers with water around Bairnsdale, but also out to Sarsfield Lakes entrance, all those, which is great.
Mm-hmm.
The $6 million project for the Wyong Basin liner, it involves the replacement and repair and drainage of pumps, floats, access hatches, under-drainage system, stabilisation of the clay liner and installation of a new geomembrane liner and floating cover. So very extensive works. The contract has been awarded to Fabtech, and so there was a lead time in getting materials. So they procured those materials over the last 6 months, and they're a company that specialises in the design and installation of geo liners and covers, so specialist contractor. The works will take about 6 months to complete, and we hope to have it finished September, October this year, and weather dependent.
Okay. What a great project, Neville. What other works have you been doing that are of interest to our listeners?
We're doing a lot of upgrades to the Lakes Entrance Water Recycling Plant over the last 12 months. We've undertaken improvement works to two primary sedimentation plants, and that was completed ahead of schedule and just prior to Christmas.
Mm-hmm.
The sedimentation tanks are used in the water recycling treatment process where sewage is stored for a period of time and allows particles to be removed in the water and they fall to the bottom of tank due to gravity. This was a $2.1 million project and replaced aged and heavily corroded infrastructure, and it'll improve the reliability of the water recycling treatment services for our customers and reduce emissions from the plant for the benefit of the environment.
Mm-hmm.
The project was a great team effort between East Gippsland Water and our project delivery partner, Jado, and a call out to Jado, shout out to Jado with that. They did such a great job, and our strategic partner, GHD, who provided supervision and technical support. This project was the upgrades will result in better process efficiency, reduced maintenance and improved safety for our plant personnel. And I underline safety in terms of it contributes to the reduction of odorous gases emissions. So when our people are working down on the plant, working on the site, they experience hydrogen sulfide at high levels, and that's quite dangerous for people. And so it was really important for the installation of these new odour covers to capture the hydrogen sulfide, and then we process it on a nearby odour control facility. As well as the primary sedimentation tanks, we have also commenced desludging of the sludge lagoon at the treatment plant. Sludge is an organic material that's removed from the water recycling process from sewage that's generated by the community. These solids then undergo further treatment in the plant's sludge lagoon. The existing sludge lagoon was essentially more than full. It was over capacity, to be quite truthful. So desludging of the lagoon was necessary. This will benefit of reducing odour and improving the recycled water quality. And desludging is the process of dewatering and reducing and removing quantities of sludge from the lagoon to increase its efficiency. So what we essentially do is remove the sludge out of the lagoon, then we're able to refill that lagoon over the next few years and helps the process.
Okay.
We'll be removing approximately 1,100 dry tonnes of sludge from the lagoon. And it's being transported to our storage facilities at Bruce's Track near Kalimna and and will also be stored at Numerella towards Coringle as well. The material is being transported each day in fully enclosed, sealed, watertight trailers with waterproof covers by Epsom Environmental Services, who've been contracted to complete the works. And the removal of sludge will be completed by the end of this month, and it's looking like it could even be this week, so that, going really well with the removal of the sludge from the lagoons.
The new role has certainly brought on a lot more activity for yourself. Thank you very much, Neville. Some really great works happening there in Lakes Entrance. Is there anything else that you'd like to tell us about?
There's heaps, Damien. Thanks. I'd like to mention some works happening at the Wood Glen Water Treatment Facility.
Yep.
Works are underway to repair a number of sinkholes that have appeared around one of our water storage basins. So we've got earthen basins up at Wood Glen, and sinkholes are caused by the erosion of rocks beneath the soil surface. The land remains intact until the spaces become too big, and then the surface collapses into the hole, causing around 100 sinkholes around the Wood Glen No. 2 water storage. So we've been out to tender and engaged a delivery partner, McInnes Earthmoving, and they are undertaking the repairs and necessary works. If we leave them untreated, they have the potential to cause safety concerns for the future. It's a project that's going to cost around $500,000, and the works involve digging down approximately a metre to a metre and a half to expose the existing sand chimney filter, so that's sand that's beneath the surface of the clay liner. Then this will then be raised and a new sand material placed in the filter trench and mechanically compacted to a density that doesn't erode the internal earth materials and weaken the embankment. So a little bit technical, but it's there to protect the dam overall.
Yep.
These works are a great example of East Gippsland Water maintaining our assets to ensure high quality drinking water provided to the customers. The last thing we'd want is these are critical water storages that are essential to our customers, and we don't want them to fail.
Absolutely. Thanks, Neville. It's great to hear about all the works happening to ensure that East Gippsland Water continue to provide drinking water and wastewater services to your customers. There's certainly a lot that goes on behind the scenes that I'm sure that none of us are aware of. What's coming up in the next few months?
Thanks, Damien. There's an awful lot that happens at East Gippsland Water to ensure we provide water and sewage services to our customers. So it's great that we get the opportunity to come on the program and provide information about what we're doing. There are a few big things on the horizon. We're planning to do pipework, upgrading some pipework and supplying pipework that provides recycled water to the Bairnsdale City Oval, and it's Class B recycled water. That's going to be an important project for providing fit-for-purpose water for irrigation on the ovals, and a huge benefit, so we're not using the valuable drinking water.
Water.
Yeah, which is great. Mm-hmm. We'll also be making improvements to the irrigation system at our Meetung farm. With the number of wet years over the last 3 years primarily, it's been a bit wet this summer as well. We've had a lot of trouble recycling the water, so improvements to the irrigation at the Meetung farm will help us in that space. And the last I'd like to mention is we've been given approval by the board. I mentioned desludging before at Lakes Entrance. We've got a very similar challenge at our Painesville water recycling plant, and we're just about to commence the desludging of the Painesville water recycling plant. So that's probably going to take about a 6-month process to desludge Painesville, but that's right on the horizon as well. So these are just a few of the projects that I'd like to highlight, and there's always general operations and maintenance tasks being undertaken by our fantastic staff across East Gippsland, from Bairnsdale and surrounds right through to Omeo, Orbost and Mallacoota. So they're working there every day to ensure that they keep the water flowing and yes, the sewage being taken away.
Well, thank you, Neville, and to the team. It's been great to hear and learn more about what East Gippsland Water Works and projects you have on. I'm sure our listeners have learnt quite a bit today, because I certainly have. Now, we always like to finish the show with a song about water. What have you for us this month?
Well, Damien, let's get our rock on today and have a bit of Smoke on the Water by Deep Purple.
Great choice, Neville, and thanks for coming in, and congratulations on your new role. It sounds like you have a lot going on. We look forward to talking with someone else from East Gippsland Water next month. Thank you, Neville.
Pleasure. Thanks, Damien. We'll be right back.
Talking Water is recorded and produced in the studios of Radio East Gippsland, REG FM.